Good morning, dear students. Welcome to our offline class. At present, I am in 8th standard first language English class. In the previous class, we already started the new poem. The name of the new poem is Palanquin Bearers. So, this wonderful poem, and it is the poem based on the description of about the bride lady. Okay, in that this poem is composed by the Nightingale of India, that is none other than Sarojini Naidu. Here we already finished the very first answer in the previous class. Now it is the time to understand the second and third. Just you have to understand once again. Okay, here gay, we gleed and we sing. Gay, we gleed and we sing. We bear her along like a pearl on a string. Softly, we bear her along. She hangs like a star in the day of our song. Here, in the second stanza, Sarojini Naidu mainly described the physical structure of the bride. So, in that, gay means here happily. Happily, when the bride lady come into the hall at the time, she expresses about her physical structure, and she is coming with a smiling face. At the time she expressed mainly about we gleed means glitter means very shining. That time that her face is beaming with delight means happiness. Just you have to understand here. One statement is there. We gleed. Here, in which tense it is the statement here? This is the statement in a simple present tense. Why? Because we is the subject here and gleed. It is the verb. How to convert this statement in simple to present continuous? Just we have to we plus R, it is a helping verb. Then afterwards we have to take the main verb plus with the ing, gleeding. This is the conversion of the simple present tense into present continuous tense. In that, how to make it a present perfect tense? We should take the same subject. Then afterwards we have to take the have. Why? Because have is the helping verb, modal helping verb. That's why we have to take have. Then afterwards we have to take the v1 verb form the verb number 3. So what is that? Gleeded. It is the present perfect statement. This the last one. How to make present perfect continuous? We have, then afterwards we have to take been, and then afterwards we have to take the present continuous verb form. Action will be here, gleeding. So this is the step we have to use in the present tense. How do we have to use this same statement in first tense? Here we gleed is then a we gleeded. Why? Because we have to take in the simple past tense we verb number 2 or we 2. Okay, then we have to change in that we are gleeding is there in the past continuous. It changed into we were gleeding. Then the third one, we have gleeded is there in the past perfect tense. We have to change into we had gleeded. The same one, the last one, past perfect continuous tense is there. How to change in the past perfect continuous tense? We had been. Just you have to change only in the place of have, we have to use had. In the place of are, we have to use were. That is the rule of the past tense. How we have to change into future tense? We shall. Why? Because in the future tense we should use the shall helping verb after the subject. That's why we have to take we shall bleed. Then the next one future continuous tense. In that, how is the statement there? We shall be. Instead of are, instead of were, we have to take there we shall be bleeding. And third, what about the third one? Third one means future perfect tense. In the future perfect tense, we have to take here we shall have bleeded. That is the future perfect tense. And finally, we have to take we shall have been bleeding. That is the future perfect continuous tense. So this is the way we have to use the formation of sentences in English grammar. It is the way we have to use the tenses in our own sentence. Okay, here in this way, Sarojini Naidu mainly described about the physical structure of the brain, and in this and we have to understand that we bear her along like a pearl on string. So that bride is wearing what is wearing? Earrings are looking like, those earrings are made up of pearls. Okay, in the next one, softly we bear her along. She hangs like a star in the day of our song. When she is coming into the hall, at that time singers are singing. That song is like very melodious. At the time, we have to understand in this way, the bridegroom also belong. Beaming with a delightful face, and the singers are singing with a melodious voice. Those are very sinking. Those incidents are very sinking at the hall. So this is the main concept we have to understand in the second stanza. The next one is that she springs like a beam on the brow of the tide. She falls like a tear from the eyes of a bride. Lightly, we glide and we sing. We bear her along like a pearl on a string. Here, in this final stanza, Sarojini Naidu mainly expresses about the beauty of the bride lady. Here, how is her eyebrows? Eyebrows are there, very attractive. Then after that, she falls like a tear from the eyes of a bride. When the people of the hall, the assembled people are looking towards the bride at the time, How she is looking? Her eyebrows are very attractive, and suddenly the shake of tears on her eyes. And finally, the pearls, her eyes tears like a pearls. That is the comparison we have to understand in this stanza. So I hope to you understand about that. So this is the comparable, the beauty comparable with other living things with non-living things. This is the idea in the composition of Sarojini Naidu. Okay, so this poem is completed here. Today itself I will send you the textual question answer of the belongs to this poem. Okay, thank you.